But what could a responsible married man be doing outside by this time of the night? I'm just tired of this nonsense.
Tired? Akaronyaganya, and you're tired? Listen, let me tell you. Fine, I can understand your position. You have put up your jersey and you are ready to play your match. Unfortunately, he's not around. But when your opponent doesn't appear, you walk him over. Put on the marriage. Do you understand what I'm saying? Marriage is not a bed of roses.
But Papa...
Listen, no. I'm telling you out of experience. You see that young man, you should be very, very thankful to God for giving you such a handsome, rich young boy. I'm telling you. Because when you see what others are saying, you won't be talking like this. You know, Nuju.
Papa, I don't even know what he does for a living.
Iji Megan, what he does for a living? What is your, what do you care what he does to live? What you have to know is that he is living, not what he does for a living. You got even Niku? This man is living and he's making you live. That is the paramount thing. Why should you worry yourself? After all, he doesn't know what you are doing here. So why are you caring what he's doing there? Why you are? Look, all these things is just to give yourself a headache. Get him his food. And they run water for him to take his bath.
My in-law.
Open your suit to the water and the shoe.
Chidi, how are you?
Welcome.
Thank you.
Right, let's eat now.
No. You cannot bring Suya and be the one to do the work of opening it. Hang on.
Come on, join us now. Come on, eat.
I don't want to eat.
Please help me with my jacket.
Chino jacket, yeah, yeah, chisa.
And get us some glasses too. Thank you. My in-law. Huh?
you're fantastic in-law. Ah, thank you, God,
to give me this kind of son-in-law.
Thank you, sir. I even thought you'd be asleep by now.
Sleep?
I can stay in this house 24 hours without blinking my eyes.
Let us enjoy.
I'm sure she has very sweet, too.
Very sweet.
Papa, good morning.
Uh-huh, good morning. You don't look so bright. What is the problem? And why are you sitting here all alone?
I was waiting for you to come back first.
Well, I'm back now. Now tell me, what is the problem?
Papa, it's Mishako. It's Mishako.
Hey! Oh, Mishak. Meshake!
You see, I told you I wanted to show that Meshake a good lesson. But you and your mother, you won't let me. What evil has it done to you again?
Papa, do you know I went to bed hungry last night? Papa, there is no food at home and Meshake could not even bring 1 naira for us to buy food.
What? What an insult! Why should he do such a thing to you? Nobody goes hungry in my own house. Why should you starve my daughter in his own house to death? He must pay for this.
He even threatened to beat me up this morning when I insisted that he should give me money to buy food. He wanted to beat me up, Papa.
Well, anyway, I'll distribute these gallons of palm wine now. And then I'll pay him a visit. If I don't see him at home, I'll take the fight to his shop.
What? Is he mad to treat you like this?
He's saying he wants to buy you a car. Therefore, who eats in the house again? Can you just imagine?
Huh? Meshach said he wants to buy me a car.
Where you go? I'm on my way to work.
You look good. Take a sip of this before you jump.
It's too early for that.
For what?
Alcohol.
This is not just my alcohol. This is blood awakening tonic. If you take a sip of this thing, and all your nerves will be straightened. Or they give you the lion. Do you understand? We know about it. You people do not. Just take a sip.
Wazi, you're very funny. Anyways, I can't take that because I have to work. But this is 10,000.
for you.
Yeah, just in case you need to buy recharge cards or something.
10,000 for recharge card. How much is phone?
Marcy, please.
Hey! God will continue to bless you.
Amen.
From where this thing came, God will replenish it tenfold.
Amen.
Your pocket will never get dry.
Amen. Thank you, sir. I have a bigger surprise for you. Much bigger surprise. But I'll have to wait till I get back from work.
Come on, I do the same thing. I don't care. You don't tell the ears to wait. I shall. He always wanted to hear the thing that I cannot wait for you to come back.
Have a nice day, sir.
Thank you.
See you later.
Thank you, John.
Wow.
What is this?
This one that your face is looking like an unswept pillow. Okay?
Papa, what you did last night was totally unacceptable. I don't like it.
What I did last night? What did I do, my daughter?
Papa, you knew I was angry with my husband. And hardly had he returned than you sent me to go bring food for him and make water for him to shower. Papa, if I had refused, it would be that Akudo does not respect her father. I don't like it though.
Akudo, I have never known you to think like a fool before. You have always been my bright daughter, the intelligent daughter, which is why I am close to you. This one that you're talking like this, has it not occurred to you that if you lose this young man, rich, wealthy young man that is making you comfortable, you are done for? Don't you know? You are done for. You have to pamper him. You have to, in fact, you have to treat him like the way you treat an egg. Ewani, this is manna from Mount Sinai.
Bonyinye, how can we be asking you what the problem is for some time now and you practically ignored us?
Oloma, if it is because of gossip you came back from school, please, go and look for your fellow gossips and exchange tales with them. Have to come back out. Leave me alone.
Onyinye. How about Onyinye? Is it because I showed my concern? Is that why you called me a gossip?
Concern? Is it by force to show concern? Is it by force to show concern on someone? Uloma, have to come back. Leave me alone.
Uloma, let her be. I'm sure she must have fought with her husband. That's why she's now waiting for her precious father to come back so that both of them will go and beat up the young man. Foolish girl.
Mama!
Come on, shut up! Inapuala! What was that for? Was that for me or for somebody else? If I hear pee from your mouth again, I will tell you that I'm your mother. Just look, that I am getting old does not mean that I'm weak. Let me hear pee from your mouth again. I will show you what fire does to the ears of a rat.
Stupid girl! Nonsense! Let me help him in your mouth again.
Where are you trekking to?
I'm going to see my in-law. We have an important issue there to discuss.
Why don't you come inside? Let me go and drop you off. Yes.
Hey, Oye Kambusi.
Hey,
you enjoy, no? Hey!
It's moving, though.
Hey! See how cool and comfortable it's inside. Hey, the trekking under the sun is suffering for us.
Yes,
it's not meant for human being.
Papa.
Hey.
We give thanks to the gift of children.
Nah, you're
if I didn't raise my son Chibike very well.
Yeah.
He wouldn't be this wealthy.
Okay.
And I would have been pumping tire by the roadside.
Hey.
And
hey.
Receiving insults.
Yes. Hey. Come on. Are you aware that Ekwueme went to Onitsha to see your son?
He didn't tell me he was going to Onitsha. Anyway, he is Chibike's father-in-law. And he has every right to visit him anytime he likes.
Hey, are you a dummy? Are you the only one in Nimo that does not know what Ekwueme is capable of doing?
Oh, but what are you insinuating?
If this case is not taken, by the time Ekwueme would have finished with your son, he won't remember that he has a father like you. Ekwueme would have taken over control of everything your son has worked for. That we are friends does not mean he would spare you. Have you forgotten the way he treated you when you went to him to borrow some money? Drink now. Come, let's drink. You may be wondering why I came to your house this early. My daughter brought a complaint to me. So I thought it was reasonable. I come to you so that we can sit down and thrash out things like grown men.
What did she say I did to her?
Did you tell her that both of you will grow hungry and die because of the fact that you want to buy a car for me?
I told her that we are no longer going to spend money unnecessarily in this house until we have bought you a car.
Meshach. I know I trust you. I know you are going to make me very proud. It's a good decision you took to buy your father-in-law a car. Is the car going to have AC?
Of course. Factory fitted AC.
Hey! Onye Kambozi. Hey! Oneku, Oneku. Hey! Thank you very much. You are a great man. I will plead with you to relax your decision a bit. Because you still need to eat. So you have more energy to make more money. You know?
Yes, it's not like I didn't know who eats. It's just that the way she was disturbing me about it, that was what made me take that decision.
I'm sorry, my son. You know, women are always women. Huh? Just take it easy with her.
It's all right, sir. It's all right.
My in-law, how soon do you think you can buy me the car? Why are you sitting here all alone?
Papa.
Are you eating?
Papa, food is not my problem now. You said you are not going to waste time where you went to supply palm wine, but I've been waiting for you here since.
Well, there's no need to be angry.
or worried. Hmm? Come. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Your father is equal to the task. Hmm? I will find a lasting solution to all the problems you and your husband have. Okay?
Okay.
Now let's go inside.
But Papa.
Come on, let's go inside.
Papa, come, Papa. But you said we're going to follow me to go and see him.
Let's go inside now.
You said we're going to follow me to see him now.
Let's go inside first. Hmm? Come. Hmm? Let's go inside first.
Oh, Papa, please, let's forget about this food and attend to my problem.
My daughter, I've gone to see your husband. Huh? And we have sorted out everything very well.
How? I don't understand.
You see, my daughter, he's not really as bad as you have painted him.
Papa, what are you talking about?
He's very intelligent. My daughter, I would want you to understand this young man. Study him very well and try to understand his good intentions. I bet you if you put your heads together more and support each other, you will achieve your dreams in the shortest possible time.
Papa, is this you talking or...?
And he has he wants to buy the car as soon as possible. And please, make sure that happens. All right? Come, let's go inside. Come on. Come. Let's go inside. Huh?
Abam, where are you going? You are not going anywhere. I told you I want to get married. You haven't said anything. You are not going anywhere. Give me the keys to this car so I can go and pick up my wife.
Abam, how else will I tell you that this vehicle does not belong to you? It is mine and mine alone. Chibike bought it for me, your brother.
Come on, driver, let me see.
Stand in my way if you think you're a full grown man.
What's the deal?
The only problem we have now is to get our own representative that will go and sign those documents. And it should be a person that won't ask any questions.
I once told you my father-in-law will make the perfect fall guy, right?
Yeah, you said something like that the other day.
Yeah. I always like to plan ahead, so I took care of that problem a long time ago. My father-in-law will be ready to sign the documents by tomorrow morning.
Are you sure he can do that without asking questions?
Just wait and see.
I want to know if your madness is getting worse or what. I used to believe that you were doing this on purpose, but you are doing a good job trying to convince me that you're really suffering from mental illness.
I've been politely asking you to hand me over the key to this car.
What type of nonsense is this? It used to be that I want to go to Enugu to collect my employment letter. Now it has changed to marriage.
Yes, you are correct. Wait,
Afam, get out of my way. I'm warning you for the last time.
That's true. I was supposed to collect that letter a long time ago. I'm running late.
Running late to where?
Enugu. Enugu. Candelim,
yeah?
Come back.
Ma,
where are you going to?
You asked me to go to the market and buy foodstuffs.
Don't go again. Go inside.
But Mama, you asked me to go to the market.
Candelim, yeah? Am I not the person that said you should go to the market? And I'm the same person that said you should not go to the market again. Go inside, I'll go to the market myself. Go inside. Go inside.
Good afternoon, Mama.
Good afternoon.
I'm looking for Nkendile.
Mama, my name is Osita, and I'm looking for Nkendile. Look at your hair. Yeah? Look at you. You're looking for Nkendile. Why are you looking for Kendall? Huh? So you are the person Ekwueme sent to impregnate Kendall? Ekwueme?
Ah, no, Mama, I didn't come here to impregnate anybody.
Then why are you here? Why are you here?
It was Uche that asked me to come and call her to see him, and that her phone has been switched off.
I don't leave my house! I thought I sent you to do what? To do what? Go and tell whoever that sent you that I have seized Nkendelim's phone. Leave my house before I have this petition to petition you now. Leave my house. Vagabond. Osita, Uche sent me. Nkendelim.
What? Why do you keep looking at me like that?
I wasn't looking at you. I was wondering if she will still come.
And who is she?
The girl you're waiting for.
Who are you? And what makes you think I'm waiting for a girl?
With the way you're glancing at your watch at intervals and sitting patiently, you must be waiting for a girl.
Are you also waiting for a girl?
Nah. I'm going to Enugu to pick up my appointment letter and start work immediately. You know, it's been a long time in the making since I was asked to come pick it up, but... How did he go?
Go what? Bros, I met the girl's mother and she threatened to break my head into 1,000 pieces if I didn't leave the house.
Are you serious?
Please, let's go.
A 1,000 pieces. Breaking the head into 1,000 pieces. Woo!
Mazi, you're looking so happy. Mazi,
yeah?
What I have in hand
is the building plan for the mansion I want to build for you. Mazi, I didn't say a house. What did I say? A mansion.
Thank you, Mazi.
You're not serious. I'm very serious. Nothing is too much for the man that gave me this beautiful woman, his daughter, as my wife.
You know, at times you get me so confused, I don't know what to start saying. Mansion for me!
Yes, sir.
God will continue to bless you. God, in fact, God will continue to guide and guard you.
Amen.
In all your endeavors. I could thank him for me. Mansion! For me!
Mazi, actually, there are 2 building plans in there. One for my father and one for you. Yes. But since you're here, you might as well choose first. Anyone you choose is yours.
Hey! Actually, you know, Chilika, at times you make me look stupid.
Mazi, I'm sorry.
I thought I have this. I didn't even plan for it. God will keep you.
Amen.
God will continue to bless you.
Amen. Amen.
Akudu, please thank him for me. Thank him for me.
Let me go and freshen up.
Ah, it's okay, you can go.
My daughter. No one has set eyes on him since yesterday.
And no one is looking for him.
There is no need to look for him. He does that all the time. And he comes back whenever he likes.
But has he been taken to the hospital?
To the hospital? For what?
Papa, I really don't think Afam is alright.
Don't waste your time over nothing. Afam is perfectly fine. The only problem with Afam is that suddenly he has become so lazy to the point that washing his own clothes is a tug of war. But I know that one day he will realize that such antics will never be beneficial to him. And he will now wake up to his full responsibility as a man.
Oh, Papa, I think you have a point. But what if I take him to see a doctor?
It's like you have money. It's like you have money to waste. Huh? Listen, if you don't have anything important to do with your money, give it to me. I, Ozoma, will spend it for you judiciously.
Are you ready, sir?
Yes.
So, all I have to do is walk into that room that you described and then sign all the papers they present.
Yes, it's as simple as that. You know, I would have actually done it myself, but you know, I don't want these people to know how super rich I am. In this country, you don't know who to trust.
All right.
Yes.
All right. I like your sense of security. Honestly.
And by the way, Mazi, I told them that you're the chairman, chief executive officer of Gemstones International Limited.
You must be joking.
Me? Mazi. My in-law, look, if you do not have money in this town,
yeah,
you're not even worth a doormat. You're not worth a doormat. So I bought you these clothes you're wearing for a reason now. Eh? I know you already have the spirit to intimidate anyone in this world, but these clothes will make it easier.
Now I understand.
So all you do is walk in there,
when you see the white man, you tell him that you're the CEO of Gemstones International Limited. He'll give you some papers to sign. You sign on the dotted lines. You know, very simple. Then you don't need to ask any questions. You don't even need to answer any questions.
As simple as that?
Very, very simple. And as soon as you're done, I'll mobilize them to come to the village and start building your mansion.
The deal is sealed.
Sealed.
I'm telling you.
As good as sealed.
Let me go.
Oyanmazi.
Yeah.
See you in a bit.
Okay. Wow. Where? What is the room number again?
Room 112.
112.
Yes.
Gemstone
International Limited.
CEO.
CEO. Very sharp Mugu. Yeah, everything is in place. Yes. Once I put the man in a chartered taxi back to the village, I'll let you know. Alright, bye.
Yes, I am asking. Okay.
Oh. How are you?
Yes, I am.
Have a seat.
Let me introduce myself properly first. I am Ekwueme of Nimo. In fact, I'm Ekwueme of the entire Boris.
I'm Mr. Pierre, please sit.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. Yes.
Okay, can you please sign here? Okay. Can you please sign here?
Here?
Here.
Okay. That should be my signature.
Yeah.
Okay.
Afam, where have you been? Your father said you did not sleep at home.
What does he know? Don't mind him. Since Tibike bought that car, all he does is drive around the whole of Nimo, seeking for notice and attention. Driving.
But you did not sleep at home.
I came back very late at night and left very early this morning. He was sleeping like a log of wood. If I had taken him off that bed, he wouldn't know.
Afam, be careful what you say about me before I place a curse on you.
Hmm? If you like, go call your cohorts, your partners in crime. And the three of you do the cursing. Trust me. It won't work.
Well, no.
Afam, I have to, there's somewhere I want us to go to.
Us?
Yes.
You and I?
Yes.
That's a good idea. But it's somewhere to go have fun. You know I don't have any money.
Don't worry about money, okay? Just wait for me here. I won't be long. Just sit here. Don't go nowhere, okay? I'll be right back.
As a man, if you don't have a son like Chibuke, your life as a father is a failed one. Just look at me. Eh? A few weeks ago, I was a vulcanizer. But today, I'm living large. I'm eating rice and chicken, drinking champagne.
Are you alright?
Jesus Christ.
Afam, are you alright? How can you let me wear this dirty thing? The same thing you have been putting on every day now.
Hey. Eh?
What are you talking about? My son.
Where? Who owns this car?
Ah! The car?
Yes.
It's mine. Chibike bought it for me now. Chibike, your brother, bought it for me. Bought this car.
Yes.
Wow.
Let me go and change clothes before someone sees me. Maybe my son is finally back home.
Baby, please, I need to talk to you.
I'm listening.
Okay. I know that my father came to see you. So I just want to know what you both talked about.
Oh. Well, you've always wanted me to get him a car. I told him that, by the grace of God, I'm going to get him a car before the month runs out.
Which car?
The car you've always insisted I buy for him.
Oh, God. Come on, honey. Like, why would I insist that you buy my father a car when... Why would I insist that you buy my father a car when the one you're using is long overdue? And needs to be changed. You've not even bought me a car, and here you are saying I asked you to buy my father a car.
Oh, hold on. Are you saying it's no longer a brilliant idea to get your father a car? I mean, something is not right here.
Oh, come on, honey. The only thing that is not right here is you buying my father a car. Sweetheart, if my father desperately wants a car, He should go and buy one for himself and not disturbing you.
Onyinye?
Baby.
Are you the one talking or am I hearing voices? Is this a plan to put me into trouble with your father?
Come on, baby.
The Ekwueme.
Look at
it. Ekwueme. One of Nemo. I really didn't recognize you.
Do you know now that I dine and wine with the white people? That you became introduced me to. Nene Ekwueme. Look at Ekwueme. Look at, this is a new Ekwueme.
I can see it, my husband.
Waneka, you should go to Chibike's place and see for yourself. That boy is super comfortable. And in fact, he coupled with intelligence. Because this boy hides the thing, nobody knows how rich he is.
Hey!
Oh, the boy, how do you?
I can see it. You're welcome, my husband.
Papa, how is Akudo doing?
How is Akudo? Well, Akudo is doing 100 times better than you will ever do in your life.
Hey, Ekwueme.
No, Rabu Kankwoku. You refuse Chibike. That was the greatest mistake of your life. Because if you go and see your sister, she looks like fruited pumpkin. You know, Leba.
Ekwueme, Ozugo.
I've told you, you continue to be a fool. You can't go on Nagano.
Ozugo.
Go to Akudo, you. In fact, I will make you visit Akudo. Anything Akudo wants, they provide for Akudo. Chibike provides it. They don't allow Akudo to stress herself. Let me tell you. If Chibike had not married any of my daughters, and the two of them rejected Chibike, I would have bought a robe for you. You to go and hang yourself where I will not see you in a hidden place because Meji Pangabu won.
It's all right. Let's go inside.
Look at me.
Let's go inside.
Look at me. Because I would have killed you myself. Then
hello, Mama.
Hi!
Oh. Hi. Now I know. Now I see why your father kept hammering that he does not want to see you anywhere around Afamefuna. Mama, just look at you. Afamefuna has succeeded in transferring his illness to you. Just tell me, where do I go from here? Where do I go from here, Ulo Mama? Where? Where do I go from here? Eh? I don't know. Look at my daughter. Where I go from here? Where did I go so long? Where did I do? Hey! Oh!
Ozoma, I was wondering this kind of speed that you are just moving. I don't know whether it was.
I was rushing.
This is the kind that if Chimoba, our friend, sees the person, Ofenye.
Oba had always maintained that whatever was wrong with my son was self-induced. Ekwueme, right in my presence, my son changed and became normal again, like a normal person.
Is he okay now?
Yes.
Oh, we thank God.
Thank God, my brother.
Do you know that your son's problem gave me cause for worry? I looked at this boy and I got so worried. So he's okay now.
That's all right anyway. When did you come back from Onitsha?
No, not long ago. But the moment I came, I decided to, you know, scout around of all the parcels of land that I own. Let me find the one that will be most suitable for the mansion that... Let your son tell you.
Tell me what?
About the mansion he said he is going to build. One for me, one for you. I have already started. In fact, I didn't want to waste time. Because Maka, the way they changed their mind. I said, let me locate the best site for him to put. Let me show you the plan. What is happening? Wanaka, what is this merry-go-round for?
Look at your daughter and candle him. Ask him candle him.
Is that how stupid you think I am?
How?
Did I see candle him before I asked you what is happening? Why are people doing this merry-go-round?
I'm sorry. It wasn't what I meant.
So what is happening? What's the problem? Huh?
Brother. Kathleen is pregnant. Kathleen is pregnant. Kathleen, you move up. You have killed me.
Is that what? Kathleen. Come here. I said, come here. Deba. Come here. Kathleen, are you pregnant? Your silence has confirmed that you're pregnant. I don't have any qualms about it. No. I'm all right with it. Provided what you are pregnant of is a bouncing baby girl, Emoramusu. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Hey!
I say hey.
Ekwueme! 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 Is that all you could say? Oh, you have killed me, Ekwueme! You can't believe he's pregnant! You're telling me he has a seed.
You want me to say more?
Hey.
What are you saying? Listen, it's because of a baby girl that I got this. Haven't you seen improvements since we started having this from in-laws? The more in-laws we have, one neck, the more we have all these goodies. Goodies that you are coming, my life is changing because of a baby. I have an in-law. The more we have girls, the more in-laws will come. The more these kind of things will come.
Ekwueme, is that all?
Oh, you want me to say more? If that pregnancy is of two baby girls, I will be very, very happy. Get me two twin girls. That will be two cars, probably two houses, probably everything in twos. So, Idi Mejima, Eba Komanare. I don't care what happened to you, provided those baby girls will grow up and take the position that you refuse to take.
I'm ready.
You want me to say more?
You're welcome, son.
Thank you, Papa.
How did it go?
God is in control, Papa. It went well. I got to Enugu on time, got to the company and met the personnel manager. He told me there are still chances of me being employed there. He gave me the information that they will be conducting another screening, after which they will invite the qualified ones.
There is hope in what you just said.
Yes, there is.
You know, son, you said that God is in control. God is truly in control.
That's why he's God.
Go to get inside it.
find in love with you. If you want to marry from this our family, make you check yourself. Oh. Unemployed graduate, teacher, civil servant, businessman with the connection. Yes.